Hey guys, welcome back to Glam Finds, and I'm here with another fragrance review. And today we're going to review this fragrance right here. It was a blind buy for me. It's from the house of Lattafa, which so far, all bangers. It's gonna be Lattafa Qaed Al Fursan. So, I'm going to read you the notes off of the official Lattafa paperwork over here. And it's going to be top notes of saffron and pineapple, heart notes of jasmine and fir balsam, and then base notes of oud wood, cedar wood, and amber. Now, when I initially smelled this, I was just not sure what they were trying to clone because a lot of their stuff are clones. I thought, you know, maybe they're trying to go for like something like Ultramol, but not really, just because it's really sweet. At least it's really sweet to my nose. It has a really syrupy sweet pineapple in the opening. Typically, I feel like Lattafas have this synthetic saffron that you can smell. This is more of a background note in here, so it doesn't come off as strong. I smell it pretty strong when it comes to their Oud for Glory or Oud for Glory Amethyst. Definitely more in the regular Oud for Glory, but this one is really not that bad. But this one is not really as strong. You're really gonna get more of the syrupy pineapple and just that fruitiness in general from this one. I think that's what you're gonna smell over everything. Other than that, it's pretty woody, but that saffron is definitely there. I honestly think that saffron note is in most Lattafas because I've smelled it so far. Other than the Anna Elbiad line, I think that's a little bit different. I think the things you're gonna get the most of is that syrupy pineapple, and then with that background of that saffron, and then it's pretty woody. However, it stays pretty sweet for the life of the fragrance, although it does kind of tame. I find that initially it is a little bit louder, but it kind of, the projection kind of softens after about an hour and a half to 2 hours. Initially, when I read the notes of this online, I thought, I think they might be trying to do their version of Aventus. And don't get me wrong, there are some notes that are similar, but the notes that are on Fragrantica are almost identical. This could be their version of Aventus, but it's a lot sweeter, and I would say maybe this is more of their kind of spin-off of it. So they wanted to take that pineapple and do something else. Again, it's really just the notes. Does it smell anything like that DNA? Absolutely not. I think it's a really syrupy sweet fragrance, but it does have that really juicy pineapple, and I really do enjoy it. This was a successful blind buy to me. If you've smelled this, what do you think this does smell like? Because typically, I mean, it could be its own thing, because again, this is different than everything I have, but Lattafas typically are clones of stuff. So for me, when I smell a new Lattafa, I try to figure out what they were going for. Let me know what you think they were going for if you smelled this, because I obviously haven't smelled every fragrance, so I don't know if maybe they're trying to copy something that I don't know about. But I will say this, it does smell different from anything that I own. It does have a little bit of similarity to Armaf's Italiano Nero in that, you know, syrupy sweet pineapple opening. It is really good though. As it dries down, the syrupy sweet part kind of tames back, and then you're just gonna get that kind of nice pineapple. It kind of almost goes a little bit tart, but in a good way. It stays pretty sweet. You kind of smell the saffron a little bit more, and then the woods kind of come out more. In terms of performance, I go nose blind to this one pretty quickly, but I know that I've still gotten comments on it, I would say about 7 hours after wearing it. So in terms of longevity, I wanna say it's average. I don't find this one to be above average. Your mileage may vary. I oversprayed it, and I would say I got between 7 and 8 hours. You could get more if you layer it with a little bit of ISOE Super, which I do sometimes, but overspraying it and getting up to 8 hours for me is good enough. It's not necessarily going to be as loud as a lot of other Lattafas, but the scent itself honestly is insanely pleasant. And again, this doesn't smell really to me like anything else. I really think that it does its own thing. I like the sweetness in this one. I like the tartness in this one. And again, and the saffron in this one isn't really as off-putting to me as it is in some fragrances. When I got Oud for Glory, I was not a fan. Like, I really haven't even given that one a full wearing because I don't really like that synthetic saffron in it. And Lattafa does put that in certain fragrances. I think it puts it in certain fragrances a little more aggressively than others. It is not, it's not as abrasive in this one, to where I actually like how it comes off in this one. And it smells really good. The other thing I really appreciate, by the way, about this is a magnetic cap, which for the price of this fragrance, I don't think you should be able to get a magnetic cap. And the box is like this, there's definitely like a texture to this box. It's a really nice presentation. All this for $25 and the fragrance actually smells good. So Lattafa, huge bang for your buck. In terms of who can wear this, I would find this insanely unisex. If you're going for something a little bit more mature, it does start off pretty syrupy sweet and it stays sweet through the life of the fragrance. You may not want this. In terms of gender, I would find this to be very unisex. It's a sweet fragrance. I think anybody can wear it. Where you could wear this, I find this to be very playful. I feel like you could pull this off on a date night if you're kind of going for like a lighter tone. I mean, if you're going to like a really fancy dinner or something like that, maybe not so much. Probably not so much a work fragrance either, although you could spray a couple sprays and honestly get away with it depending on where you work. But to me, this would be like a nice fragrance to go out with friends. I think you could wear it day or evening. This is not a very cloying fragrance because I've worn it in the day when it was hot. Do keep in mind that I live somewhere that is not humid at all, but I have worn it during the day and it's not cloying. It's actually really pleasant. People are going to like it. This does get compliments, especially during the beginning of the fragrance, especially in the first couple of hours. It's going to be getting you a lot of compliments. People enjoy this scent a lot. Again, if you want to get 8 hours, actually potentially over 8 hours, spray pretty heavy. You can go 20 sprays and be solid on this one. I will also say this. I spray myself and I usually don't get to where I'm going until like 45 minutes later. So by the time I get anywhere, my 20 sprays are exactly what works for me. I just want to tell you guys that in case you're throwing 20 sprays of anything on and going somewhere that you're going to get to in 5 minutes, that's going to be a different ball game. So I think this is about average performance. I think it's going to get you compliments. I think if you're going somewhere playful, you could totally rock this. I would go lunch, anything outdoors, season-wise, spring, summer. I don't know if this is going to hold up to the cold, so I would kind of keep it to the warmer months. If you've tried this, let us know down below. Let us know what you think. Let us know compliments, performance, because performance may vary. And again, I go nose blind to this, so the only reason that I kind of know that it's gotten me to 8 hours is because of the compliments that I've gotten. It's got really good compliment getting DNA. Pineapple seems to be a note that is just going to do really well. And sweet fragrances tend to do really well, especially for me. Price-wise, you can pick this up for $25 on fragrancebuy.ca. If I find it anywhere else, I'll link it down below as well. As always, thank you guys for watching. Remember to like this video if you liked it. Be subscribed to my channel. Hit that notification bell to get notified when I drop new videos. And I will see you guys on the next one. Bye!